Every quadratic form is specified by a matrix A, but not all properties of A are equally important. You can always diagonalize A. The P matrix is only performing a rotation if you put the columns in the correct order, so it does not matter too much for the overall shape. The shape is more determined by the diagonal matrix D, so by the eigenvalues of A. And from the eigenvalues, it's actually not so important whether they are, say, 2 or 4. Larger eigenvalues just mean that the function grows a bit faster. But what makes a difference is whether the eigenvalues are positive or negative, because that will have a large impact on the overall shape. And that is why quadratic forms are actually classified according to the sign of the eigenvalues, as you will learn in this video. So, about classification of quadratic forms. So, there's a quadratic form again. F equals x transpose times A times x. A is symmetric, so A equals P times D times P transpose. So, you can find some new variable y, such that F of y equals lambda 1 I y1 squared plus lambda 2 times y2 squared plus lambda n times yn squared, where lambda 1 up to lambda n are the eigenvalues of D, and so they are also the eigenvalues of A. Now we are going to classify the quadratic forms. First, formally say, f of x is called positive definite if your function f of x is always bigger than 0 for all x that are not equal to 0. Of course, for x equals 0, you get just f of x equals 0, obviously. Now your f of x is called negative definite if your quadratic form is always negative. So if f of x is always smaller than 0 for all x not equal to 0. And what else do we have? Well, if your function takes on both positive and negative values, then your f of x is called indefinite. So that's the third option. Now how can you see that? Actually, that's pretty easy. If you look at the expression over here, now suppose all your eigenvalues are positive. Then you have a positive number times a square plus positive number times a square plus positive number times a square will always be positive. So if all your eigenvalues are positive, your f of y is always positive. Same and your quadratic form will be positive definite. Similarly, if all your eigenvalues are negative, you have a negative number times y1 squared plus a negative number times y2 squared and so on. So your f will always be negative. So that's 1 plus 2. Your f of x is positive definite if all your eigenvalues are positive. And your f of x is negative definite if all your eigenvalues are negative. And if you have both positive eigenvalues and negative eigenvalues, of course, you get an indefinite quadratic form. That's the third case. Now, how can you see that in an explicit example if you look at the matrix A? Well, this f of x looks positive definite. You have 1 half x1 squared plus 1 half x2 squared. Looks quite positive, right? Okay, we have this mixed term, but what does it matter? Well, actually quite a lot. So if you form your matrix A, then you can compute your eigenvalues. You can do that yourself. They turn out to be minus 1 and 2. So then in the Y language, you can get rid of your mixed term, and then your quadratic form becomes minus y1 squared plus 2 times y2 squared. So, and then you see that, in fact, this quadratic form is indefinite. So, if you want to determine whether your quadratic form is positive definite, negative definite, or indefinite, you always have to get rid of the mixed terms. And then, so you have to look at eigenvalues, and they will tell you the answer.